Starting with the name of Allah Almighty, who is the master of the day of judgment, and a bundle of the religious name on behalf of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. Dear students, mathematics, exercise 8B for new secondary mathematics book 1, abstract students for class 6, and exercise 10B for new syllabus mathematics B1, and question number 1 is, in the figure, A, B and C, D are two parallel lines and we have to prove A, B and C, D are two parallel lines whereas P, Q and R, S are transversal lines intersecting A, B at point W and C, D at point Y whereas R, S is intersecting A, B at point X and C, D at point Z. And students, in question number 1, first part, we have to list down two pairs of equal corresponding angles. Students, keep in mind that corresponding angles are the angles that are above the parallel lines or below the parallel lines and on the one side of the transversal. Students, again try to understand. Corresponding angles of parallel lines are the angles that are above the parallel lines or below the parallel lines and on the one side of the transversal are called corresponding angles. So students, angle 1, angle 2 are corresponding angles because both angles are above the parallel lines and on the one side of the transversal. As well as students, I can name this angle as angle 3 and this angle as angle 4. Angle 3 and angle 4 are corresponding angles because both the angles are below the parallel lines and on the one side of the transversal line. As well as students, this angle 4 and this angle 5, these two angles are also corresponding angles because these two angles are above the parallel lines and on the one side of the transversal, I mean to say on the left side of the transversal. So these two angles are also corresponding angles. Whereas students, angle 6 and angle 7, I should name it as angle 5, not angle 4 because angle 4 is already written. So, I name it as angle 5. So, angle 5 and angle 6, these two angles are corresponding angles whereas angle 7 and angle 8 are corresponding angles. In the same way, students, if we draw the angles on this transversal line, the angles that are above the parallel lines and on the one side of the transversal are corresponding angles, as well as on the below of parallel lines and on the one side of the transversal line, these two angles are also called corresponding angle. Whereas students, this angle and this angle are corresponding angle, this angle and this angle are corresponding angle. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 and there are 8 pairs of corresponding corresponding angles and we have just to write 2 pairs of corresponding angles. Students, for naming the angles, either we can give them the name as A, B, C, D or 1, 2, 3 and we can also name this angle 1 as angle P, W, B as well as B, W, P is angle 1 and we can say this angle as angle 1. So it is totally up to you that in which way you want to write the angle. So students, two pairs of equal corresponding angles are angle 1 is congruent to angle 2. These two angles are corresponding angles. Angle 3 and angle 4 are corresponding angles. Angle 8 and angle 7 are corresponding angles. And angle 6 and angle 5 are corresponding angles. In the same way, students, I can name this with the small letters as A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H. Students, in the same way we can name this as angle A is congruent to angle B, angle C is congruent to angle D, angle E is congruent to angle F, and angle H is congruent to angle G. All these angles are corresponding angle and we have to write only two. So students, if you want to write this in this way, you can write, and if you want to name them by capital letter, so you can name it as angle 1 is written as angle PWB is congruent to this angle is congruent to angle PYD. Angle PYD. We can write this angle 1 and angle 2 in this way. And angle 3 and angle 4 can be written as angle 4 is read as angle QYD. Angle QYD. This angle will be congruent to angle QWB. This angle. So angle QWB. These two angles are pair of corresponding angles. Friends, second part of question number 1A part is two pairs of equal alternate angles. Now students, you must keep in mind that what the alternate angles are. Alternate angles are always the interior angles of parallel line and on the opposite side of transversal. Students, I am repeating. Alternate angles are the angles interior angles of parallel line, means both angles will be in the interior sides of the parallel line but on the opposite side of transversal. I mean to say angle 7 and angle 2 are alternate angles because both angles are the interior angles of parallel line but on the opposite sides of transversal line. As well as angle 3 and angle 6, both are alternate angles because these two angles are the interior angles of parallel line and on the opposite side of the transversal. On this transversal line, angle C and angle G are alternate angles because these two angles are the interior angles of parallel line but on the opposite side of transversal line, and angle E and angle B, these two angles are alternate angles because both angles are the interior angles of parallel line but on the opposite side of the transversal line. So students, we have to write only two pairs of alternate angles, and here are four pairs of alternate angles, so I will write all the alternate angles. Students, angle 7 is congruent to angle 2. These two angles are alternate angles. Angle 3 and angle 6 are alternate angles. Angle E and angle B are alternate angles. And angle C and angle G are alternate angles. All these angles are alternate angles. Alternate angles are the angles that are the interior angles of parallel lines and on the opposite side of transversal. So there are four pair of alternate angles in this figure. Students, third part of question number 1A part is we have to write two pairs of interior angles which are supplementary. Students, keep in mind that the interior angles of the parallel lines on the one side of the transversal are called interior angles and these are supplementary angles. So angle 2 plus angle 3 is equal to 180 degrees. So these two angles are supplementary angles, interior angles of parallel line. As well as angle 7 and angle 6, these two angles are supplementary angles of parallel lines and these are interior angles. Angle G and angle E, these two angles are interior supplementary angles. And angle C and angle B, these two angles are interior supplementary angles. And we have to write two pair of interior angles which are supplementary. So students, here are four. I will write angle 2 plus angle 3 is equal to 180 degree. And reason is, all the reasons are supplementary angles are interior angles of parallel line. So I will write it only once. And then students, angle 6 plus angle 7, these two angles are equal to 180 degree. Angle E plus angle G is equal to 180 degree. And angle C plus angle B is 180 degrees. So all these angles are interior supplementary angles. Interior supplementary angles. So students, it is a part of question number 1. Students, B part of question number 1 is angle BWQ. BWQ is this angle BWQ. BWQ angle 3 is BWQ is equal to AXR. AXR angle H. We have to prove that either angle 3 and angle H are equal. Students, if these two lines, if PQ and RS are parallel lines, then angle 3 and angle H will be congruent angles, because these two angles will be then alternate angles. Now students, these two angles are also alternate angles but not parallel lines, so these two angles are not equal. So we will write no. Reason is because PQ is not parallel to RS. Students, again think that why angle 3 and angle H are not equal although they are alternate angles? Because alternate angles of parallel lines are equal. So students, these two angles are not equal although they are alternate, because PQ and RS are not parallel lines. Is it clear, students? Suppose students, if these two lines are parallel lines and it is a transversal line, then this angle and this angle will be equal, and these two angles are called alternate angles when these two lines are parallel. Keep in mind students, when two lines are parallel and then there is a transversal line, then the opposite angle of transversal line and interior angle of parallel line will be alternate angles, and that are equal. So angle H and angle 3 are not equal. Students, C part of question number 1 is the sum of angle DYP. Look at DYP. Where is D, students? DYP. DYP is angle 2. So first we will write in this way, DYP plus CZR is equal to 180 degree. So angle DYP is angle 2. Angle 2 plus CZR. CZR angle G is equal to 180 degree. Now students, look at angle 2 and angle G. Although these two angles are interior angles, but the sum of angle 2 and angle G is not 180 degree, because PQ and RS are not parallel lines. Students, look at these two lines. These two lines are parallel. Then the sum of angle 3 and angle 2 will be equal to 180 degree. Although angle 2 and angle G are interior angles of these two lines, but these two lines are not parallel. So and the sum of angle 2 and angle G is not equal to 180 degrees. So the answer is no. And explanation is PQ is not parallel to RS. It is the explanation. As PQ is not parallel to RS, so the sum of interior angles will not be supplementary. So students, it's enough for today. May Allah Almighty bless you all the time. And have a good day.